right, guys, we are on the road to Lubaantum archaeology site. We're almost there, maybe a half a mile, and I just wanted to kind of get some of the road going in. And this is my little dog, Luna. She's the inspiration for my adventures with Luna Dog. So we're in Belize, the southern part of Belize, very, very south Belize, at the Lubaantum archaeology site. So let's go check it out. I usually don't drive with her here. She has her own little car seat that, well, she buckles in with this and the other side. But we're on this little dirt road, and I'm just letting her sit here for this short little part because I feel like it's safe enough. Here we go. Sorry about the glare, guys. There's not a lot I can do about that. Here we go. It's really, really pretty. There's a big cornfield on my left that you can't see because my mount's facing, the way it's situated on my windshield, it's facing towards my right, and it doesn't like to go the other way. I would have to totally remount it. San Pedro Columbia, which is it's in South Belize. It's an odd name for a village, but that's what it's called, San Pedro Columbia. And look at this really cool house over here. Chaos Oasis. Oh, they got juice. It says juice bar, but I'm sure, I don't know if they're there. But it's an interesting house. You can see it. On my left, there's these really cute thatch roofs. Huts are really cool. So I think this is it. We're coming up upon it. I'm going to pull into parking here. Park here. Where do I park? Over there? Okay. Nope, I'm not. I'm good. Thank you, though. Thank you so much. I was warned by my Airbnb host to don't use him as a tour guide because you don't really need one. It's a waste of money. And poor guy is trying to earn some money, I get it, for his livelihood, but he said he's going to be more annoying than be full of information. He's annoyed people, I guess, in the past, but I told him no thank you, as you heard, and he was fine, so let's hope it stays at that. All right, so I've parked. Let's get through emissions, and I will show you Lubaantum archaeology site here in South Belize.
Okay, I was told that you need to walk down these stairs where the office is, and that's where you pay. They've got bathrooms and some vendors over here. And I thought this was the admissions, but it's not. It's down these steps, so I'm going to take a walk down these steps. So I think I'm about halfway there. It looks like I'm going to be going up some stairs here in a minute. Maybe I'm not quite halfway there. Now I'm halfway there, but this is, or a little, maybe a little over halfway there, but I think that the hard part is coming up, going up all these stairs, but it's not a big deal. I need the exercise, so let's do this. Okay, I'm at the top, panting like a mother, And we've got the mission person walking over to check me in. Okay, so this is not for the physically challenged, because you might say I am, but I just need exercise, so I'm good to do. I'm good to go. But if you have any knee issues or back problems or something, I'm not sure how you would fare. It's your judgment call. But this is pretty steep. I got to. The other stairs weren't that bad. It just, you know, take your time, you're fine. But these are pretty steep, so let's climb these. Okay, here's a down-looking view. See the steepness of it. And let's see what we see. I will get the facts for you later. Probably narrate this voiceover. We've got these structures here. And one thing I've learned is that they usually have two types of courtyards. One is a marketplace, and another will be like a ceremonial yard, courtyard type of place. This is like I'm not sure, actually. It could be ceremonial because you've got the stairs going up pretty high on either side, right here. I don't know. I didn't look at the facts first. That was probably my bad. I was going to look at them later. I like how these trees are growing out of the structures. And trees are hundreds of years old, so you know that these structures are definitely very old. They seem to be around 500 AD from the other three sites I've been to. They don't always like you to climb these because it wears on them. So they usually have trails along the sides. You can go up at the top and have a view from the top. If you find another way up around the side, usually is what I've found so far. These runes, it's gorgeous. Say hi, Luna. Say hi. Let's go up. Stand in the shade for a minute, and then we'll go up on the side of this one and see what kind of view we have up there. So pretty. Fire pit or something. Oh yeah, we got some structures over here. Check it out over here. Oh, I hear water close by. That would make sense. If the water was there hundreds and hundreds of, or thousands of years ago, anyway. Oh, a trail through there. Look at that tree, that's cool. Those roots, that's so cool. Nice breeze, it feels amazing. Very steep. There's a little trail around where we just were. We were looking down to where we're going to go. And now we follow this trail down there. We don't use the steps. These vines. I'm the only one here at the site right now. I was the only one at Nimli Punta as well the other day. There's just so many scattered throughout Belize. It's not like there's only three. There's a lot, so. So I'm on top of a little mound. sure if I'm supposed to be up here or not. I didn't see a sign saying I couldn't, but it was only a few steps, and it's not like I climbed over a lot of the old archaeology steps to get up here or anything. But you can see, maybe even here, there's a river right down in there. I just was. looks like some kind of an altar. Hi, Luna.
Luna Dog.